Welcome guys to war number 4 of season 18. This time round 4 Loki is matching New Nation. A tough opponent, one of the best alliance in war. And this is one of my worst wars, so prepare and enjoy me getting destroyed. So we have the global Stubborn, and this first fight, it's versus a Nova. And the plan is to use Doom for this fight. Shouldn't be any difficult, even though I didn't read the node and I don't even remember what the node is. But yeah, it's not the intercept one. Yeah, you have a bit of a power drain here, but I don't really care. I nullified his fury. Now going ham. I will be spamming the special ones and trying to. Oh yeah, it's the power one. He didn't use any special now. I'm trying to get to my special 3. Trying to bait a special here. He finally uses it. Blocking most part of it because I don't really care if I die, if I lose health with Doom here. I took off suicides, as you see. Now I'm trying to get to the special to my special 3. And here after a combo, okay, got to the special 3. Now the plan is to get to special 2 and melt him down really fast. I have Mystic Dispersion on 2, I think, for this fight. I can't really remember. Anyway, here medium light here, special 1, and didn't get enough power to get to the special 3. Another special 1, but here I triggered the invulnerability. I wanted to use this special 1 again because he was getting vulnerable from the Stubborn. Now I use my special 2 on the fury bonus, and I see he's melting. One more combo here should do the thing, and end with a bitch slap. Okay, and next fight, again using Doom for this fight because it's MP modification, so Doom is immune to shock, so best here to use. And to use versus Mordo because of his power gain, I shouldn't have any problem using Doom here. Should have a lot of power and could spam specials and finish the fight really fast. So here for going for a combo is Finn ending with the heavy, so now I have a stagger, but he used the heavy, so I didn't remove the power gain with stagger, so I didn't get his power gain. But again, now he's waiting in the corner because of the... Okay, now I got the power gain. And he's really defensive because whenever Mordo should gain power from the power gain, he should he stays a bit defensive holding his block. So that's why I got parried there. I went in and he's usually so defensive that you can't really hit his block if you are not really careful. But this fight with Doom, it's a bit slow. Okay, finally get to the special 3. Now using the special 3, getting some power, getting the power after my combo here, and should go to a special 2, and this should almost kill him. A special 3 does a lot of damage, so that's an advantage for using Doom. Here I didn't get enough power. Special 1, now to the special 2, popping my special 2 here, and this should melt him really fast. You see 1000 a tick with the incinerate, and he's down. Again, a really good fight with Doom here. Next on the path one in section 2, we have a Venom on Vigor, so I'll be using Void for this fight. Should work be really good because of Stubborn. It helps Void with the perfect block, and this is a Venom, so shouldn't be any trouble here. I still have suicides off, so that's an advantage. Using Void here, I can spam my special ones as much as I want. Here I was checking if I started recording, I couldn't remember. Using the special one, triggering by mistake. The Venom is defensive, so that means he's invulnerable now, so I need to get hit in the block or straight in the face. Again, I triggered this on I'm getting a bit annoyed that I triggered it on the special one, and I plan from now on if needed to block the special one. I don't really want to push into the special 2, and here I had enough range to evade it without triggering invulnerability. Now he's healed block finally, so I won't, the vigor won't matter anymore. And I'm rushing with my special ones because I want to get to Fear of the Void and do some real damage. Here he finally used the special one, so Venom is usually really aggressive, so he usually uses his specials really fast, but in this fight, the special one, he wanted to hold it a lot. But nevertheless, he's going down, and you see that I'm almost still at 100, almost 100%, I'm full health here, so Void really good with this perfect block. And nothing difficult here, just need to be careful to not get hit by Venom. Because a few bleeds could really kill me here, and now Venom is down. Next, so remember when I said this is my worst war? Well, prepare, because we didn't get to the part where I start dying. Anyway, again we have a Hulkbuster on Buffett and Lionheart, so can't use Void to reverse the healing. The plan here was to use Quake. I think this is a rank 2 6 star Hulkbuster, so it's stubborn, and this guy is defensive, so the plan is to play parry heavy all the way. I trigger a bit of evade here, now I trigger the parry, and now I'm playing only heavy parry. I mean, I know it's not quick deck style, but you can't use versus stubborn dexterity. I mean, you could, but sorry. But it takes, you have to be, to have a good timing on the, you have to get hit whenever you dex you, at the end you have to get hit on the block or and or pay or something, because if you trigger invulnerability you don't do damage at all, and even though they have concussion, it doesn't matter, you trigger dexterity and that triggers the invulnerability. So, relying on the parry heavy method. And one thing I want to add here, so I have a mini boss fight, and I was thinking, okay, I'm going to take that fight with Void, so I need suicides off, and I said, okay, I have to quake without suicides, shouldn't be any difficult, just a bit longer on the fights. Well, I mean, this, it's my own doing. I should have put suicides on, because I'm pretty confident when quaking, but longer the fight, the bigger chance to get mistakes, because your hand gets a bit sore, and that's pretty ugly. Sorry for the yawning. Yeah, I don't know what's about that. Waiting here for this, the warlock to be cleared. Now warlock is clear, so the plan here is to use quake. And because warlock is not defensive, I'm gonna play only full deck style quake. I quaked warlock before, so this fight shouldn't be any that difficult, even though it's a 6 star rank 3. If I'm really focused, this shouldn't be any difficult. I don't care about the node. Here I trigger dexterity, I need to trigger one more time dexterity, come on, be a bit aggressive. Okay, trigger dexterity, and now I don't care about Buffett. The only thing I care about is dexing in the corner. So remember, I took suicides off. And this means I do less damage, and the fight will take longer. You see that I'm doing like 10% every aftershock. So that means 10 times the aftershock, or 9 times because of assassin. But anyway, doing pretty well here. The fight is going pretty good. And I'm dexing really good, even though warlock is a bit harder to kill because of the way he is really aggressive and does a lot of combo in the corner here, and doesn't dash back at all. You see that he's coming at me a lot, and here not getting hit. Okay, the fight is going pretty well, 35%. So I think, okay, 3 more aftershocks, then he uses a heavy there. I evade, I'm doing really good even though he uses a heavy, and then I drop by mistake my heavy, so I healed him a bit, and now I guess hit in the face here. I'm getting a bit panicked. Okay, I should have reversed to try and do heavy parry because my hand was hurting at this moment, and yeah, do a mistake and die. Pretty annoying that I die with Quake. This is, I think, the first time from when I started using Quake in War to die. And yeah, if I had Suicide Zone, he was already dead at this point. So suicides really help Quake. Now I revive, I heal Quake here. I decide, okay, I don't really need full health to finish this fight. I was pretty upset how this fight went. Here I'm trying to trigger dexterity. Okay, I trigger dexterity and I healed him from buffet again. So that's annoying to start the fight again. And I decide, okay, I'm trying, let's get the quaking back in action. I should have waited a bit to rest my hand of 1 or 2 minutes, and here I do a mistake and die again. Damn, this was so frustrating because I knew that I should have taken a bit of a break. Now, I took a 3 minutes break or something like that. I healed Quake again, got her to heal to full. You see that I have only one item left. I still have the boost running because I boosted pretty, not big, but medium boost. And I pop an inverted boost because I don't want to die third time to this warlock. And yeah, let's get back in action. 60% and still no suicides, so I decided, okay, no suicides, and I get hit again. They're unlucky with indestructible, so now I really need to pay attention and try to finish this fight. I'm really focused here, and I was really upset because dying 2 times on a fight. Yeah, and that was not about rushing in. Okay, maybe it's about rushing in, but I was confident in the fight, so I didn't expect, okay, I died, no worries, I heal, I revive, and I take it the second time. But as you saw, I died second time there, but this time around, hopefully I'm quaking really good. You see that I'm back on my point of quaking, how I did the first part, the first time I died. So the fight is going pretty good. Should need 2 more aftershock, and he should be down. Okay, again, being really calm here, 1 more aftershock should kill Warlock, and yeah, I'm not dying here anymore. Warlock is down, finally he goes down, and I have the last fight of this war. We have a Tigra or rank 5 star Tigra on a mini boss with rage and stubborn. So I tried before to quake this fight, and yeah, it didn't go too well. Her animations are a bit awkward, and she has a double medium mid combo, which is pretty new and hard to adjust to. So I decided, okay, I'll be using my Void here. It's a Mystic. Void crushes Mystics, shouldn't be any difficult. If she could just use her for her special one, and I decided, okay, I'll push her to the special two. And this was a big mistake. I get hit by the special two a lot, getting corner. You see that I don't know what's the debuff that Tiger placed on me, but I'm taking a lot of damage, and the disadvantage is her specials are unblockable, and I'm cornered, so really hard to get out of this corner. Her heavy is annoying. I get hit again and taking a lot of damage from those debuffs. Again, the heavy I finally evaded, but the thing is, he uses a special one here. I block it, I survive it because of the perfect block from Stubborn, but now another special one, and yeah, I didn't evade this. So, third time dying this war. This it's deja vu for the last season where I died 3 times in a war, and that was my worst war of that season. This is the worst war from this season. Okay, decide to use Quake here and to play Quake Parry because I couldn't dextile. I tried in the corner to dextile, but yeah, she's really annoying, and I'm playing a combination of Quake here with Parry, with heavy dropping heavies because I know I don't need too much to kill her. I was really upset that I died with Void, and my biggest mistake was pushing her to the special two. If I just paid being calm and waited for the special one to be used, I wouldn't die, because that special to push me in the corner, and her specials are really hard to evade in the corner. Here I'm doing pretty well. Again, I get hit. This fight, it's all awful, even with Quake. I'm trying, okay, give me the aftershock, and she's down finally. But died 3 times and lost the war anyway. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.